You walk towards the house, but within a few minutes, you realize you aren't getting any closer. The voice of an old woman speaks to you.
What do you seek here, strangers? Yes, yes, gone they are, all of them. The light came, earth parted once more, and this time it was not empty inside. All who see it are taken or destroyed. No in between with that lot. That is what I said and saw. A light so bright, it is darkness. If it finds you lacking, you wither away and become air. It devours, it takes, it does not need or want. It does only as it will. Perhaps. All I know is the demons were there one day. Then they all changed, filled to the brim, overflowing inside, driven by emptiness, driven to walk away from their nature. A force, perhaps. They saw the light and are gone. My hut knows how to hide, so we hid. We watched. We waited. Me and the toad? The only ones left. The shmoo? Oh, the toad. Well, it is not as it seems. It was there in the middle. Saw it all. I doubt its tiny mind comprehends. But if you take its curse away, maybe it could tell you more. It is not a shmoo, obviously. It is a cursed thing. And that is why it stayed. The light was too weak to break it, to take it. That is good. Or is it? Not really, no. But you must know demons are made of magic. We are bound to it, bound to laws stronger than our own will. We cannot break those bonds. Not without other bonds, prices, deals, tricks. Those who left, they just left. How? Kiss it, yes, that will work. I take a wee bit of your blood, then you kiss the toad and I prepare a ritual. You will need to have a strong spirit to help break the curse. All who wish to partake will lick the toad 3 times. Then take the sweat from their armpits and mark the creature's face with it. This way, I will join you all. The curse will then attack you too. If you succeed, you may break it. You will likely be stung by the magic, but nothing more.
The curse breaks, and the kmurch turns into a tall young man with golden fins and gills. His eyes sparkle like gems. Thank the waters, that was insufferable. I am a Vodnik. I was courting a Rasalka, and it's strictly forbidden, you see. Anyway, her slimy sister turned me into the dumb creature. I tried to get it on with another Rasalka. It is forbidden, but, well, I am a prince, I suppose you could say. My father is the Vodnik who rules over our waters, so I thought I could get away with it. Yes, yes, I'm not going to marry one of your rugged lot, you can forget that, but I can give you a few trinkets in thanks. It's also very foggy, my dear. The kmurch was so undignified and dumb. I felt a touch of something. It was burning, yet ice cold. Light, but in its purest raw form. It spoke of unison, order, ultimate peace. It sought to touch me, but the curse kept me hidden. The others, They were not so lucky. I saw them walk so straight, so depleted of life yet living. They went towards one of the chasms left by the Shattering. Then they were gone. Oh, that's sweet, but no.
The witch who came with you waves goodbye as well.
Off I go then. Did my bit. Hope you get him, whoever them are.
As the sun rises, as you brace yourself against the heat, you soon see that the sun's rays are full of odd creatures. These light wisps are trying to attach themselves to you with their tentacles, and they are burning. You resist the assault, and your domain exudes a burst of darkness.
Thank you.
You'd best move along. You're no friends of ours.